Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to the Cathedral of Our Lady of the Angels, and a special welcome to those joining us via the Catholic channel of Sirius XM, as well as the ABC localist channel 7.2. Today is the 22nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our priest celebrant is His Excellency Archbishop Jose Gomez. Before we begin our Mass, please take this moment to turn off all cell phones and any other electronic device. Thank you. Our opening hymn is We Belong to You, number 865 in your hymnal. Please stand and sing hymn number 865.
We belong to you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today, as we celebrate the 22nd Sunday in Ordinary Time, the Church is especially asking us to reflect on our Christian vocation, how we are called to love and imitate our Lord Jesus Christ and share that beautiful love with the people of our time. So let's start our celebration acknowledging our sins and preparing ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, my thoughts and in my words, what I have done, what I failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Heavenly Christian, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Christ is risen.
Let us pray. God Almighty, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. You duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped. You were too strong for me, and you triumphed. All the day I am an object of laughter. Everyone mocks me. Whenever I speak, I must cry out. Violence and outrage is my message. The word of the Lord has brought me derision and reproach all the day. I say to myself, I will not mention him. I will speak in his name no more. But then it becomes like fire burning in my heart, imprisoned in my bones. I grow weary holding it in. I cannot endure it. The word of the Lord.
You are
us to you. Your right hand upholds me.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
Matthew. Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you. He turned and said to Peter, "Get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to me. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do." Then Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with his angels and his Father's glory, and then he will repay all according to his conduct. The Gospel of the Lord.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, this weekend we are celebrating especially because every year, as you probably know, at the beginning of the month September, on September 1st, we celebrate the Feast of Saint Bibiana, patron saint of the Archdiocese. And on September the 2nd, we celebrate the dedication of our cathedral. So today we especially give thanks to God for all the blessings that we have received in the Archdiocese through the intercession of St. Bibiana and the ministry at our cathedral. As you also know, we have the relics of St. Bibiana downstairs at the side of the St. Bibiana Chapel. So it is always good to ask the intercession of St. Bibiana, the patroness of the Archdiocese. It is also Labor Day weekend. So let us give thanks to God for the gift of work, and pray for our brothers and sisters in our country who need a job, and for the courage to build a world in which God's gifts are better shared. And the readings that we just heard are, as I suppose we can understand, are challenging. In the passage of the Gospel, we just heard St. Peter, rather interesting dialogue with Jesus. Jesus is telling St. Peter and the other apostles for the first time that he has to go to Jerusalem, where he's going to suffer and be killed. And St. Peter protests. As we heard, he said to Jesus, "God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you." St. Peter loved Jesus, and he doesn't want to see Jesus get hurt. But he really doesn't realize what he's saying. He's basically asking Jesus to save himself. He's trying to talk to Jesus out of the cross, trying to talk him out of doing God's will. So Jesus tells him, "You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do." My brothers and sisters, it is our human nature to be afraid of pain and to want to avoid suffering. We want that also for the people that we love. But sometimes God allows sorrow and hardship in our lives. So the question for us is, how are we going to respond? What are we going to do with the suffering that comes to us? And that's what Jesus is teaching St. Peter in our Gospel this morning. The lesson is this: God has a plan. God has a plan for our lives, for your life and for my life, and a plan for the whole world. In God's plan, Jesus must allow himself to suffer and die on the cross. And by losing his life, Jesus gives us new life, eternal life, to all of us. So we have to trust in God's plan. trust that he's in charge of history and our own lives. And we also have to carry out God's plan to conform ourselves to God's will for our lives. You know, sometimes it is difficult for us to understand the meaning of suffering or sickness. Sometimes it seems impossible for us to see God's purposes. We all have challenges and crosses in our lives. That's what Jesus is telling us today in the Gospel. He tells us, whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. They are challenging words. But there is something beautiful about the challenge that Jesus gives to us. We carry our crosses, but we don't carry our crosses alone. We are walking with Jesus. We are carrying our crosses with him. And we are all following Jesus together, all of us. We are walking with one another in the church, with our brothers and sisters. It is a beautiful solidarity, a beautiful communion that we have in the church. We're a family. All of us, brothers and sisters. This is why the church is so active and does so much good in our community. Helping people, lifting people up, promoting human dignity and social justice. We are here to pray for one another, to help one another, to bear one another's burdens. So, Jesus is telling us to carry our cross with him and to carry our cross with love, just as he did. Jesus lost his life so that we could find our lives, that we could have eternal life, as he is calling us to offer our lives to God also, out of love. St. Paul says in the second reading that we just heard that we need a whole new way of thinking. He said, be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God. So my dear brothers and sisters, God's will for us is simple, but it is beautiful. God wants each of us to be holy, to become a saint. And the way to do that, as we know, is following Jesus by carrying our cross in love with him. St. Paul also says, offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. This is the way to live, to do everything for love, to make our lives something beautiful that we offer in love. For the good of other people, for the glory of God. By our love and sacrifice, we give life and love to other people. So, today, let us renew our love for Jesus and our desire to share his gospel with everyone in our lives and in our world. And may our Blessed Mother Mary, who followed Jesus to the foot of the cross, help us to take up our cross and follow her son. And may she help us to embrace the challenges and suffering in our lives with love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Please stand for a profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, life from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified with Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life for the world to come. My brothers and sisters, trusting in the boundless generosity of Christ, who took up his cross out of love for us, let us offer our prayers before God.
Let us pray for Archbishop Jose Gomez and all bishops. May the Holy Spirit bless their ministry as they lead, guide, and serve God's people. Let us pray to the Lord. For those in civil authority, may they dedicate themselves to justice, peace, authentic freedom, and the generous defense of the poor. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For people living on the margins of society, in inhumane life conditions, may they not be overlooked by institutions and never considered of lesser importance. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation, on Labor Day, that our work will be directed to God's glory and that the unemployed will obtain suitable work. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christian husbands and wives, that the Lord will strengthen them in their vocation and make them witnesses of Christ's love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they rejoice forever in the Father's glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, you are our help. Your kindness is greater good than life. May we bless you in our daily lives, always calling upon your name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Following the Lord means nothing less than the cross. Offering ourselves with Jesus as a living sacrifice and not conforming ourselves to this world. Following him will entail derision and scorn, yet the Lord is our help. I invite the ministers of hospitality to pass the baskets to receive your gifts. Thank you for your generosity.
Amen.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that we celebrate in mystery we may accomplish in power. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just,
our dear, and our salvation always and everywhere. To give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. By rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and made them whole. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, but from the rising of the sun to his setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, whose command we celebrate this mystery. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wonderful resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose aid you will to reconcile us to yourself. And that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, that we may obtain an inheritance for your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Viviana, and with all the saints, whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and me, your unworthy servant, my assistant bishops, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family. You have summoned before you, your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the Lord, on the world, all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we will be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, say to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord. order that should enter into my home. Only so the Lord of my soul. May the God of Christ save me.
Please join us in singing our communion hymn, number 862, Christ in Me Arise.
Christ in me arise.
Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and steer us to serve you in our neighbor. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. In observance of Labor Day tomorrow, September 4, Archbishop Gomez will celebrate Mass at 9 a.m. There will be no confessions and no 7 a.m. or 12:10 p.m. Masses tomorrow. The parish offices, gift shop, and Galero Grill will be closed. Today, we will host the girls' choir from the Cathedral of Freiburg, Germany, who will be giving a special concert at 4 p.m. We hope you will join us for this beautiful concert. The organ concert series returns to the cathedral with an organ recital every first Wednesday of the month. Our cathedral organist, Soo Hyun Kim, will launch the monthly organ series this Wednesday, September 6th, at 1 p.m. The concerts are free and open to the public. Please visit the cathedral website for more information. At this time, we would like to recognize anyone who is here at the cathedral for the first time. If you are a first-time visitor, please stand and be recognized. Welcome to the Cathedral of Our Lady of the Angels.
Please stand for the final blessing. So I hope that we continue reflecting on the beautiful message of today's liturgy, and especially continue to have the beautiful understanding that we are walking with Jesus and serving our brothers and sisters, especially in our families and the people around us. But also especially on Labor Day, pray for the reality of the beauty of work and that people that need to have a job that they have possibility of being exercised in that beautiful part of our life that is working and giving glory to God in our daily lives. The Lord be with you.
Bow down for the blessing.
May the God of all consolation order your days in his peace and grant you the gift of his blessing.
Amen.
May he free you always from every distress and confirm your hearts in his love.
Amen.
That on this life journey, you may be effective in good works, rich in the gifts of hope, faith, and charity, and may come happily to eternal life.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Please join us in singing the Salve Regina, number 1000 in your hymnal.
Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, Espes nostra salve, a te clamamus, exsules filii ebe, a te suspiramus, flentes in hac lacrimarum vale. Ea ego advocata nostra, vivos tuos.
singing our closing hymn, number 878, Glorify the Lord by Our Lives.